Okay, Dave Foster here, and in this tutorial video, I'm going to again go through and show you. I'm going to create a G+ cover image because I want to update that. It's been the same for a long time. So I'm just going to kind of walk you through how I do it again. Again, this is Keynote, which is a Mac program. It works the same with PowerPoint. So if you kind of follow my steps and then just kind of do the same thing in PowerPoint, it might look a little different, and there might be a little bit, you know, different features and stuff that you can do. And I don't know some of the stuff that PowerPoint can and cannot do. So you're just going to have to, play with it and see what you can do. So the first thing I'm going to do, because I don't remember the exact size of the G+ cover photo. So you've got all your graphics here, and in the bonuses, we've got the backgrounds for social media, G+. So I can see that they're 940 by 179. So I'm going to move this over here. I'm going to come here to my size, and I am going to change it to a custom slide size. And I'm going to go 940 by 179. And it might not let me do 179. Nope. So I'll go 200. So it's going to end up being a little bit bigger, but I'll show you how I can do that too. So I'm going to go with a blue, like I did yesterday, because I love blue. Let's see. I don't know that I like that one though. Let me see what all we got here. Circles. And that makes sense because they're G+ circles. So let's use that. I like that. Okay. So I'm going to line this up, kind of in the center of this, and the reason is when I grab it with Jing, I want to be able to, you know, see my white edges, and if I move it all the way to the top, I won't see that. So, okay, I'm going to kind of design this like I did the other graphic yesterday. So I'm going to go back here. I'm going to go to the graphics, and I'm going to go for the shadows, pics, and videos. And I'm going to grab a different one this time. Let's see, shadow background. Okay, so that's pretty cool. So I'm going to make this smaller. And actually, that's going to have to be pretty small. And remember now, your image is going to be on this side on G+. So I'm going to move this all the way over here. And put it right about on the edge, right there. And then I'm going to pull in our logo. And put that here in the center. And if you got the guides on, I mean, it'll center it and everything for you within that image. So, okay, that is centered. And let's just put some kind of text on here. David Foster. And then Hubsy, CEO. I don't know why I'm going to put that. That's just what I usually put. I'm going to increase the font size on this. Bold. Going to go white text. I'll put that over here. Let's see. I think my image actually goes all the way up, so I'm going to have to put it here. I can show you how you can do that as well, as far as find out where the image is. So I'll do that here after I get this set up. Now, because I'm going to have to capture this with Jing, I have to learn the spelling of CEO, because that red line would be in my main image. If I could have went smaller than the 179 or the 200 width, I wouldn't have to do that. But since it won't allow, like with timeline, I can do it, so I'll be able to show you better when I do a timeline cover image, and I'll do another one of those to show you. Okay, so I'm going to move that there. I think I'll move it up a little bit because I'm going to say something about my blog, too. Blog. www.hubsy.com. Okay, I'm going to make that white too and enlarge it. And all I'm doing is hitting command plus. Okay. And as I told you before, with the font, I prefer Tahoma. So I will open this up and I will go to my favorites Which, oh yeah, this is not my iMac. To whom? I have to search all fonts. Tahoma. And I'm going to drag this over to my favorites because it is my favorite font. There we go. And make it a little bit smaller than that. 24, that should be good. And I want this to be Tahoma as well. There we go. Now I have shading on the top one. I'm not going to put it on the bottom. I kind of think that looks cool like that. Now I'm going to go to my G Plus profile real quick and kind of show you how I do this. It's probably, you know, not the right way. I know that with Photoshop you can do a lot more if you know what you're doing with Photoshop, but I don't, so I have to use all these shortcuts. How did I get logged out? There we go. I don't know what I did. Profile. Profile. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take Jing and I'm going to capture this exact size here. A little bit past the edges. Save. And save to my desktop, which is getting full again. Okay, now pull this over here so I can see where. Okay, so see, they don't actually, the image is a little bit. Okay, there we go. So I can see right now that my image is going to be between there and there and the whole width. Okay, so I can already see that CEO is going to be blocked. So, I will then make this a little bit smaller so that I can move this over. Oops. Grab both and move those over. And all I did is hit Command as I was selecting them so that I can grab both of them. And I'm actually going to fill this color white. And no line. Okay, and that's pretty even. So there is where my image is going to be. So I know what room I've got to play with now. So what else could I put on here? Or is that enough? That could be pretty simple. I don't know that I necessarily want anything else. Let me look in the mega pack here and see what else we got that I could put in here. Buttons. Yeah, let's do the check marks. So, you know, I could do something like that. I mean, that doesn't really fit. I don't like that, so I'm not going to do that, but I could do that. I really think that this is good. I mean, it says exactly what I want to say. We just added our slogan, Simplifying Social, to Hubzy. It looks clean. I like how it's got the circles because of the G+ circles. So, yeah, I think I'm going to go with that. So now what I do is I know that the image is 9. Let me go back and make sure that I know exactly, so I don't tell you wrong. G+, 940 by 179. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to capture and go to 179 here. Oops, 179. And then go 940. 40. Okay. So there I go. So I can see it's a little bit white on the top. See why I left the white up there? Because when I move it down too far, right here you can see that little bit of white. So I want to move it up. There's no white there. No white on this side. That side's fine. So now I am ready to capture my image. And actually, I'm going to cancel because I just thought of something I'm going to do. Since this is going to be behind my image, I'm going to try something and see if it actually works. I don't know if it will or not. But let's add a shadow here and see if that, let's bring this to the front. So it's in front of that shadow. Let's see if that adds the shadow under my main image on the thing. So let's see what it does. It might look cool, might look dumb. Okay, so let's capture again. 179 by 940. Okay. Looks like I got that perfectly that time. So I'm going to capture. I'm going to save to desktop. And now I'm going to go to Google Plus, change cover photo, and I'm going to upload. Move this out of the way. Drag this over. And it is uploading. And it is taking quite a while, longer than it normally does. Sorry, we could not save your cover photo. Please try again later. Okay, let's try this again later. Now is later, right? It's not liking this graphic for some reason, even though it's perfectly the right size. There it goes. Okay. So, it didn't add the shadow like I thought. And see here, for some reason, that part of it is missing. And I don't know why. That's odd. And this is over a little far. So I'm thinking maybe that's the wrong dimension. Kind of looks like it was moved to the left. So let's see if I can reposition. Cancel. So it doesn't look like I can reposition, but that's weird that it's showing blank here because this is how I've done it the other times, and it has been fine. So let me try something. So, okay, I'm going to remove this. And so it looks like it's got to be smaller here. Move this over here. Center this with that. Move this up. And I'm going to move both of these over to the right. I mean, this is how, you know, I mean, I do trial and error because it seems like about the time you've got all this figured out, they both, Google, Facebook, all of them, seem to not care about changing dimensions on us on things and just not telling us, you know. I don't know why they do that. They just do. So you just got to, you know, play with it. I mean, pretty easy to do. Just get it to where it looks right, and as long as you keep it open and don't close it, you can go in and make edits as many times as you want. And believe me, I usually end up making quite a few because there might be a little subtlety that I'm not happy with or something like that. Okay, so now I'm going to grab this again. 179. By 940. And if this doesn't work, then I'll show you what I do when I usually can't figure something out. Okay, save this. Save. Desktop. Okay, now let's go in here and change cover photo again. Upload. Grab the new one. Put it in there. I'm glad this is happening because now you can see, you know, how I do this when I have an issue. Because there's a lot of trial and error that goes into social media, let me tell you. Okay, sorry, we cannot save your photo. Please try again later. Do it again like I had before. Come on, baby. Come on. There we go. All right, see now that for some reason lined up correctly. I don't know why the other one didn't, but see how, I mean, I grabbed the exact same size, and now the CEO thing would have been fine, but I moved it, and so now it's different. Now I'm going to change this because I got the R from the old one, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this again, and I'm going to add my shape. Make sure my lines are lined up perfectly. I'm going to go with the color fill and no line. Move this over to end up right there. Put this up. Okay, so now that's where that's at. And that should be the outer edges. So now I'm going to grab my picture of me. Dropbox. Here it is. Okay. Make it smaller a little bit. Right there. So my head is about even. It does drop down just a little bit. So now what I'll do is I will put a line. I'll go with no color fill on this and a line, and I will make the line white and a lot smaller than 2 pixels. Okay, so now what I'll do is I will come over here, and you can see that it does go up a little bit higher. So I'm going to make it go up just a little bit higher right there. Okay. Now let me move this down. And I will move this down. And make this a little bit bigger. Okay. So now trying to see how big the buffer is on this. So looks like it does go perfectly, just about perfectly even with the bottom. So just a little bit past. So it looks like the buffer that I have in there is about right. So now the one you got the snap to on, I'm going to have to actually size this automatically or like this. Incrementally or whatever you want to call it. Center me in this area. Okay. All right. So it looks like I got the buffer about right. So now what I'm going to do is I am going to capture this. And I'm going to capture it by the lines that I have in there. So like this. There's my line. Get that right there. Okay. Let me see. Yeah, that looks about to be right. That's right there. So capture image, save, save to my desktop. Now I'm going to come back here, change profile picture, drag this thing over there. Yay. Oh, it's too small. Must be 250 pixels wide and 250 pixels tall. So we've got 250, 250. So, okay, that helps. So now all I got to do is come here, capture, and make sure that I go 250. Okay, so that's clear down. That's clear down here by 250. So that's going to be... So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to grab another shape. Actually, I already have that shape there. I'm going to grab that, and I'm going to make it 250 by 250. Okay, so that's fairly large. And I'm going to make this black now, because now when it's going down into the white, I can't see it. So I'll make it just like gray. So see, now I can see it. And I'm going to center myself in there again. Let me make sure. Now this is right to the edge. So let me make sure that I'm centered in there, which I am not. So that means my box is off just a little bit. So let's move my box over. Okay. Yeah, see, this is... It's a little bit off because it's centered in the box. The thing is off. The image that you upload. So, you know, that's going to make it just a little bit difficult. But I'm going to make this work. You watch. Okay. So now, let's try this. Capture. And it's got 222 there. So let's go to 50. Okay, let's move this up just a little. All right. I don't know what this is going to do, but let's see. Change profile picture. Drag it over. Okay, we know it's 250 by 250. So I guess let's just leave it like that. See what happens. Set as profile photo. I'm not going to share. Okay, see, so we are a little off, but it does, you know, it does look cool. I mean, it looks okay. So I'm going to leave it like that. Click done editing. And there you go. Now, I know I do have some area under there that I could do something. But, you know, I mean, right now I'm not going to mess with it. But I could expand this image and make it work. But, you know, I can't figure out why the size... Because when I'm viewing this, the size that I took off of here is smaller than you actually make it. So it's like it's compressing it down. But I'm happy with this. So I'm going to stick with that. So that is how you create a Google Plus image. And like I said, don't be afraid to trial and error this and get your sizes right. Because you can actually, you know, I've seen people who have things that continue on. I mean, I had done that once, but then they changed the size and kind of messed it up a little bit for me. So... I wasn't able to do that again. So let us see your creations. Post them on our wall or post them, you know, wherever we are so we can see. Post them on our Google Plus page if you want to. We have one. Just search Hubzy and you'll find it. Thanks for watching and watch for another one coming soon. I'll do Twitter background, YouTube background, stuff like that just as time goes by. So thanks. Have a great day.